It's an honor to represent the United States Postal Service as we celebrate the science behind the exploration of our nearest star. Since the dawn of recorded history, humans have been fascinated by the sun. Its ability to provide light, heat, and energy has served as a source of mystery, awe, and sometimes fear. At the center of our solar system, the sun's intense energy provides the precise conditions for life on Earth as we know it. And thanks to the pioneering contributions of many scientists, engineers, and technologists, we know more about the sun today, its influence on our planet, the solar system, and beyond than ever before. The modern field of heliophysics, the study of the sun and its influence on space, has made great strides over our early understanding. NASA's heliophysics program is part of this learning. Their solar research helps shape our understanding of how the broader universe works and how to protect our technology and astronauts in space.
Heliophysics itself is the study of the sun and its interaction with everything in the solar system. Inside the Earth, we have molten metal. And when you have a liquid metal that's super hot, it has electrical properties. And when those liquids move, they generate magnetic fields. And the similar thing is happening inside the sun. If you were on part of the surface of the sun, you would see all these crazy structures coming up, because it's actually not this simple, smooth object. We're sort of familiar with the sun in terms of giving us heat and light, but it spits out lots of material and energy, electromagnetic fields. But when it hits a planet, especially something like Earth, we get to see this interaction. The aurora, the northern and southern lights, are a manifestation of that interaction between the sun and the Earth. And so what we're learning is about this whole environment that's created by the sun. And it's an environment which becomes more and more important to us, because not only does it interact with technology, things we have around the Earth like satellites and spacecraft, but as we go to places like the moon again, and eventually to planets like Mars with human beings, we have to understand that environment, because we have to travel through it.
As on Earth, you have different weather events, like for example, you have tornadoes, you have hurricanes, you have earthquakes. The sun is a star, and it's actually changing all the time. It's evolving, it changes the complexity. Because of that, it can have also different patterns and different events of weather. And when those, which we call solar storms, happen, those are actually can travel through space and affect the Earth environment, and also arrive at different planets and missions across the solar system and actually cause damage to them.
Sometimes these solar storms and solar flares can cause temporary radio blackouts, so you can't communicate with certain frequencies of radio. Some of the larger storms can create electrical currents in the upper atmosphere, which can then be picked up on the ground, and those can impact power grids. So fortunately, it doesn't impact our health directly or us physically, as long as we're here on Earth. But then it's another story if you're actually outside of the atmosphere and outside the magnetic field, traveling to, you know, the moon or another planet.
But the idea is for us to understand and give a better warning to the astronauts in space of what's going on. But that's a challenge when you have half an hour or an hour to do it. So you pretty much have to do it before the event happens.
Continued research holds the promise of new insights in the development of life on Earth, activity on other far-off stars, and conditions on planets outside our solar system. The sun's churning magnetic fields create the solar activity we see on these stamps. Sunspots, coronal holes and coronal loops, plasma blasts, and solar flares. The striking colors in the images do not represent the actual colors of the sun as perceived by human eyesight. Instead, NASA colorized each image according to different wavelengths, allowing us to visualize these solar activities that we could never see from Earth.
The images that are on the stamps are from the Solar Dynamics Observatory. They're grayscale images, and we pick actually very specific color tables to use.
And that actually helps you see different layers of the sun within the surface, and also the magnetic field, and also the solar atmosphere, which is the solar corona, which is where most of the solar storms that can cause space weather effects originate from. For example, you have 193 angstroms and 171 angstroms. Those are the bronze and the yellow ones. When you look at those, you're actually looking at eruptions. exactly what happens in the solar corona. You see dimming, you see changes in that solar atmosphere when the eruption happens. But when you look at 131 angstrom, that's the steel blue. So from that one, you can actually see where the solar flare happened. Now, going a little bit more lower in temperature, you look at 304 angstroms, that's the red one. With that one, you can see the eruption coming out. So as a scientist, you begin to believe and see and understand how the sun as a star evolves and how it actually changes and what actually happens within that magnetic field that it has. And within that, you also understand how it actually affects Earth.
One of the things that's important about the sun is that, you know, it is the center of our solar system. Indirectly, we are taking in this energy from the sun, not just the light we feel on our skin, but through the plants and other things that we ingest. So understanding the sun is really critical for our lives. Just by looking at that little stamp, we can see it in a way that we can't even see from the Earth.
Having those stamps available to the public, they actually will intrigue a lot of those young generation to understand why they're different colors, how the sun can be viewed in all those different colors. And maybe we can get more heliophysicists out there in the future.
We hope these stamps will help generate the same sense of wonder and curiosity about our star that inspired our ancestors and the scientists at NASA to want to better understand the sun, space, and the myriad of possibilities that exist in our solar system, in our universe, and beyond. Now, at this time, we're pleased to present the Sun Science Forever stamps.